the deep transformative thing is that I'm coming closer and closer to thinking in Hebrew. And Hebrew has fewer words than English, so it's much more nuanced. And with its root system and grammar, it's much more playful. And I should also mention that all the encounters I have described all happened in Hebrew, and wouldn't have been possible for me to have experienced them if I hadn't begun learning to speak the language. And, you know, speaking the language in English is an expression and a metaphor for so much more than speaking a language. It's about being able to participate in a whole culture and a whole inside joke, as it were. So to be an informed rabbi, come to Israel, travel around, speak with anybody who you can understand, and even people that you can't, you know? Like, if you don't understand Hebrew fully, still let somebody's tirade in Hebrew wash over you. You'll learn something from that experience, nonetheless. Let somebody's tirade in Arabic wash over you, and just come with open eyes. I was walking down the street yesterday evening at dusk, and I noticed near a corner there was a delivery truck pulled over and a man kneeling on a prayer mat, prostrating towards Mecca. And it would have just been so easy to not notice it, but and I'm sure there were people who walked by and thought, you know, chaval that this is happening in a Jewish state. But, you know, I just thought that it's so beautiful, you know. There's so many little details here that can delight, just as there are so many little details here that are heartbreaking. But I think the most important thing is, for me anyway, is to come here and feel it.